Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. It's been a massive day of sourcing today. I've gone out and I've bought everything and I've brought it all back to the house. So a little bit different style of video to what I normally do for a day in the life, but it's sort of in two parts today. I've gone out first of all and I've done a heap of retail arbitrage, and really I haven't done a whole lot of this. So this has all been a brand new experience for me, but I'm glad I went through the process because I think you want to find other different ways to source your items. And I've always known retail arbitrage is definitely something to consider. So I'll get out to the outlets today. I went to the Nike store, Adidas, I went to Under Armour, ASICS, went to a heap of them and they all had really good discounts, but it's a matter of finding that resale value online. So I had eBay with me the entire stage and I was searching the comps there to see if we could find a middle ground of about 25 to 30% profit margin. And then I was typically trying to buy those items. So I've got a bit purchased, which is great. And then I went to the thrift stores as well because I couldn't stay away. And I bought actually a fair bit in there as well. So in today's episode, I'm gonna sit back and it's gonna be a bit of a two-part. I'll show you what I bought for retail arbitrage and I'll show you what I bought in the thrift stores. Hopefully you can find the same items out there at the same prices and make the same profit. So let's get into it. We'll kick it off with the Adidas store, which is my first stop. So my game plan going in today was to try and find shoes between 50 to 70% off. And I went into the Adidas store to kick off the day and I've been able to buy these Adidas Ultra Boost 19s. Awesome colorway, red and white. And I've paid a grand total of $78 for these. Now, the breakdown went, they were $260 in full retail, but they already at the outlet had them marked 50% off. So they were down to $130. And from there, a certain allocation of shoes had a further 40% reduction in price. So when you put the 40% mark off on the $130, these worked out as 78 bucks. So not a bad result for some $260 shoes. Now, they're not this year's model, but they are 2019. So I thought I'd pick these ones up. I'll put the receipt here for you to have a look at. But for $78, I needed to see then what it actually sold for on eBay. And eBay was showing me that it was about $130 with free post. So when you take your fees and you take some postage out of that, it's gonna be about $105. I paid 78 bucks, so the difference there is a $27 profit to me. Now, my first crack at retail arbitrage, doing it, there was a whole lot of shoes in there that weren't adding up to a $27 profit, even though they were heavily reduced in the store. But I wanted to really go by what I was seeing on eBay, rather than just going by the great deal that was in front of me. So these I've gone ahead with. I've just bought the one pair. I bought a US size 10 men's, because that obviously sells pretty well. It's a good common men's shoe size. But 78, 105, $27 profit to kick things off at the Adidas store. My first pair of shoes, retail arbitrage. So I thought I've done it right there at the Adidas store, but then I went right next door to Nike, and the Nike factory outlet has some ridiculous promotions. Now, as you can see behind me, I've ended up buying four pairs of shoes here, and I've got the receipt here. I'll whack it up here for you to have a bit of a clearer look, but I've bought the Nike Flyknit 3.0s. They're black and white, I'll show you in a second, but I've bought four different sizes, but they're all men's shoes. The comps on eBay was one reason why I bought these. There were a lot of them on eBay selling. They were selling on eBay for around $120 to $130, but the promotion in the Nike store, they were $200 retail shoes, marked down to $90, and then the promotion was take a further 50% off the marked price. So that means I've bought these shoes for $45 each, and they're $200 shoes. So I'll take one out of the box for you to have a bit of a look at here, but this was just a ridiculous, $45 for a pair of $200 shoes, I thought, why not? Now, look, they aren't the best shoe in the world. I personally wouldn't buy these shoes myself, but they are comping quite heavily on eBay. There's been a lot of sales for these, the Flyknits, the 3.0s. I deliberately bought just the plain black and white because that was the model that was selling well on eBay. There were a whole heap of different colors, colorways there, but just this standard black and white shoe, it was selling well. And they were selling on eBay for about $120. So, you know, I thought for 45, if they're selling on eBay for 120, that's a very high profit margin for retail arbitrage. So I've just stuck with, amongst scanning every other shoe there, I've just stuck with this model because it was just the best one. Now I've invested $180 into four pairs of these shoes, but remember they do retail for $200 for just the one pair. So, you know, when you look at the numbers, again, you're gonna have to take your fees and postage out of the $120. So it's gonna be a similar sort of scenario. You're basically gonna pay, you're gonna get $95 in your pocket selling these on eBay for $120 with free delivery. So $95, I'm actually buying these for $45. There's a $50 profit there. So it's about a 55% profit margin on these shoes. So I was shocked when I saw a profit margin that high out of a retail store. let alone a heap of comps as well on eBay. So I've bought the four pairs here. Now, if they do sell, the potential profit in these four pairs of shoes could make me $200. I've invested $180 and they could turn into $380 worth of sales. So I was really happy to find that in there. I was crunching the numbers like mad, but these shoes were just, you know, not the ones that I personally would buy, but that's not what you're in there to do. You're in there to find what sells well and what gap can you get? What's the biggest difference you can find in the profit margin? So to see these at 45 and to know that they sell on eBay for 120, the Flyknit 3.0 Nikes, they are the way to go. So I spent about $250 all up, four pairs of Nikes, a pair of Adidas's, they're going okay. So I went into the Under Armour store next, and there were a pair of Hover black and white men's shoes that I think were around the $60, but the reason why I ended up passing on the Under Armour shoes was just simply because of the resale value on eBay, or more so really just the lack of sales on eBay for these Under Armour shoes. Now, they were a great discount, don't get me wrong, as were a lot of the deals that I saw in these outlet stores, but just because there was a lack of sales on eBay, I just thought I'd steer clear. So I didn't end up buying anything in the Under Armour store in the end. I also had a peek in the ASICS store as well. Now, I love my ASICS, if you've watched any of my previous episodes, so I was really hoping I could find a good deal on a pair of ASICS to show you, but every pair of ASICS that I saw, the best sort of offer that they had available was 50%. And if it wasn't 50%, it was 30 or 40% off. Now, at those discounts, I don't think you're going to find much of a profit margin when you go and resell on eBay. So I think that there was a pair of Cumulus 20s, ASICS Cumulus 20, and that was a good 50% off. But really, I'd be stretching to make a couple of dollars with that, even that purchase. So I didn't buy anything in Under Armour. I didn't buy anything in ASICS. But then I went to TK Maxx. Now, TK Maxx is a store out of the United States predominantly, but there are a few more popping up here in Australia, and I've only just sort of clued in on it. But I bought two different items in the TK Maxx. One was these socks, Ben Sherman. It's a three-pack. Now, Ben Sherman's a great brand, but these retailed for $35, and I've gone ahead and I've bought them for $5. So they had a really good promotion on the socks, just $5 socks for a three-pack of Ben Sherman's. $35 retail. I'm going to put these up onto eBay for $22, free postage, plus postage for a $30 spend. It already comes under the retail price and it's delivered for them as well. So hopefully it gets a few nibbles. Now, at a $5 spend, that's a $17 profit. Take a few fees, you're going to be looking at about a $14, $13 profit on a pair of socks. So I went out and I bought a heap of those, these sort of Ben Sherman 3-packs. I figured that's going to be a small retail arbitrage win, a very low price at $5, so I had to get those. And I also bought a pair of Calvin Klein men's underwear as well. Now, everyone needs socks and jocks, so that's why I'm sort of playing in this space, because I feel like, especially even leading into Christmas, there'll be a lot of purchase in this category. Now, the price of these on a retail were, hopefully you can see that there, but $60. So these are $60 Australian, and they were doing these for $17. So TK Maxx had a $17 price on these, and they cost me $60, or retail is $60. So I'm thinking if I put them on eBay for about $40, take off the $17, that's $23, take off some fees as well, you might be looking around the $20 profit for these. Now, they do retail for $60, so by putting them on eBay for $40, it's still a pretty good discount for them to want to go ahead and purchase. And obviously I've bought them at $17 from TK Maxx. So I'm hoping that's going to be a $20 profit there. I have bought two pairs of these for $17 each. So I've spent $34. I'm hoping to make a collective $40 profit on them. We'll see how we go. I'm not too sure. But through the maths, these just seemed like a good idea because they were $60 retail. I got them for $17. And hopefully they can sell for $40 on eBay. We'll see. So that was everything on a retail arbitrage front today, guys. I bought the five pairs of shoes, I bought the socks and the jocks. Hopefully there's a bit of money to be made there on eBay. Remember, these are just my numbers that I've put into the thought process of buying the shoes. I've actually now got to go and sell. So hopefully I can bring you the results on my Sunday What Sold video. But hopefully you got a bit of a kick out of that. Let me know in the comments below what your best retail arbitrage item is, or what you've sold for the best return when you've gone and done a bit of retail arbitrage. It's new for me. I'm still learning, but I'm happy with the results to kick things off today. I've bought a heap of shoes as well in the op shops though today. So I'm going to show you those. I've bought 9 in total. I even found 5 pairs of shoes actually in one op shop. So I'm going to go through that first op shop with you right now. I bought the Nike Shocks. So these were a really cool pair, Nike Shocks, great colorway. I've spent $8 for these. So there it is just there. So $8 for a pair of Nike Shocks. Now, I have sold a pair of these only a few weeks back for about $50. And these are in very good condition. There's no wear on the soles. So are ready to go, $50. I'll give them a light clean and they'll be fine. So that's a quick $40 with those. I also found the footy boots. I think these footy boots will sell for about $40 as well. They are actually a better Nike footy boot. You can get the entry level type boots. These probably aren't at the entry level. They're a really nice pair. It does say Kangalite. It says Magista as the brand or the make, I guess, of the Nike shoe. In good condition, nothing wrong with them. A lot of dirt and stuff to clean off, but I've paid in total $6 for these. So an absolute steal, $6 for a pair of Nike footy boots, and they are a good make. The next ones as well. How cool is this colorway? I found these. Now these are a Nike Air Zoom. They're a US 7.5, good women's size. They are in great condition. Not a lot of wear on the soles. I've paid $12, so I paid a little bit more for these, but I think these will sell for about $30. So it might be a pretty good return there of about $20 in the end, hopefully. But they were just a really nice shoe, in really good condition. When you're paying just $12, good pair of Nikes, good return. So that was good. I found these as well, which are more of an older school Air Max. So Nike Air Max, definitely an older style. I don't know how old, I'll have to do some research, but these are in great condition. I've paid $8 for these. You'll see just there. So $8 for the Nike Air Maxes. That was in the one of the five. So that was, what's that, four. Oh, I also found these, another pair of Nikes. These are dual fusion light. So dual fusion light, as you can see, I've paid $8. Cool colorway on these ones as well. Great soles, nothing wrong with them. Paid $8, look to sell for $25, maybe. Hope to get about a $17 to $20 profit, depending on where they fall. I'll put them on Facebook Marketplace for $30 and just see how we go. So they were all in one op shop, if you can believe. There was only about 25 shoes on the rack and five of them was those. So couldn't believe it when I saw those. Went into the next op shop and I found a pair of Nike Air Maxes. Now, these are a pair of really cool pink colorways. I've paid $15 in the end. You'll see that there's a $20 tag there, but I asked the lady behind the counter if she could do a better deal for me, and she said she could do them for $15. Now, I reckon I can get about $50 for these, and let me know in the comments below if I'm putting the wrong price on them, but I think about $50. They are in pretty good condition, not a lot wrong with them. I'll give them a really good clean. But I'm hoping that I can make myself about $35 profit on the Air Maxes. I just really like the color. And the size is in my favor as well. The size is a US 8.5. And these are a 2013 Air Max. So a little bit old, which I kind of like as well. I went into another op shop and I did find the ASICS Gel Kayano 25s. Not a lot wrong with these. I'm going to give these a really good scrub. There's only some slight wear in the discoloration here, but there's not a lot wrong. The soles have still got quite a bit of wear left in them. I've paid just $8. Now, these, if they're in perfect condition, they can resell for about $100. I reckon these are going to go close to $100. There's nothing wrong with them, and they are actually the Gel Kayano 25s. So they were very much a later model as well. One of the latest, actually. I think they might be even up to I'm not 100% sure where the Kayanos are up to on the numbers front, but a 25 isn't too bad. I'm hopefully able to get about maybe $80 for these, maybe 90. We'll see how we go, but they're going to sell well on Facebook. And then I found another two pairs of Nikes, more so your entry-level type of Nike. The first one were these Revolution 4s. So Revolution 4, I've paid... What did I pay for these? $7. So I paid $7 for these. I'm going to hope to sell them for about $25. So that could be a really quick $18 profit on Facebook. I'll give these another good clean as well. They should be fine. And then my last pair of Nikes that I found for $6 was the Free Run 3s. So a Free Run 3, a really sort of entry level type shoe. Not a lot of wear, again, a good clean, and these ones should be fine as well. $6, I'll hope for $20 to $25 and make sort of anywhere between $15 to $20 profit with those ones. So awesome one for number 9. They were all the shoes that I found, and then I found some clothing as well. I found this really cool Ralph Lauren men's polo. So I just really like the stripe pattern to it because you often just see these in the plain, you know, blue, red, whatever. But that small logo, this kind of cool stripe pattern to it, bit of uniqueness about it. I don't see too many of the patterned Ralph Lauren polo shirts around, but this one's a size medium. So that's okay. I've typically sold these for 25 to 30 on eBay, and they do move pretty quickly as well. So I'm gonna go buy it now, 25 bucks, just move it quickly. I think I actually paid $10 for that, but I'll still go for a $25 profit because I just know that it sells quick. Found the Levi Strausses as well, so awesome to get those done. It was a waist 34 and a length 32. So that's just really, for me, the pocket that I like to play in with denim jeans is to try and get a size 34 because that's one of the most common. I've paid $8 for these ones, so just $8 for a pair of Levi's. They're gonna sell very well, maybe $30, something like that. So that's cool. I found, what do we got here? Oh, so as I mentioned about the plain Ralph Lauren's, I found another plain Ralph Lauren. So I'll give this one an iron and a clean, but that one's in good condition. I paid $5 for this one, and this one's a medium as well. So again, hoping to sell that for about $25 pretty quickly. So for $5, that's a good return. A very plain Nike tee as well, this one. Says about that game. So this one was just $7. It's a size XL. Cool color, cool logo, Nike tee, maybe $15 on marketplace. It's only a quick $8, but I just couldn't say no to it because I knew there was more profit in there than not. I found a Tommy Hilfiger polo. So this one was a pink with the small logo. This one is a size medium. I'm gonna try and sell this, like the Ralph Lauren polo, for $25 as well. I paid $7 for this one in an op shop. So seven, the pink, kind of cool. That should sell fast. I found a jersey. I found a New York number 7 Carmelo Anthony. This is a kid's jersey. So the size says large, but by no means is that an adult size large. So I grabbed that. I think that'll move pretty quick in the kids range. I don't typically buy a lot of kids wear, but I still think that's gonna be a bit of a profit. And then I found some really cool sort of band t-shirts as well. I've started to search for these a whole lot more. I found an old like Japanese style Beatles top. So have a look here. That just come back a bit. So it's, yeah, Japanese writing. It's got Lady Madonna, The Inner Light, The Beatles, and then there's just some Japanese text in there as well. So, you know, I don't know. That might sell pretty well on eBay. I've got to do some comp searching and see if I can find a certain price. It's a size large, but when you see that in the op shops, you just want to give that a bit of a try, just see how you go. The next one that I found was an absolute classic Bowie t-shirt. So I grabbed the David Bowie top. That one was only $5 as well, and that's a size large. So that was a good find. I also found a Pink Floyd top as well. So a standard Pink Floyd, standard logo. That one is a size medium, but that will sell for, you know, I don't know, $20, something like that. And then I found Don't Blink Doctor Who. So this was just a cool logo as well. Don't Blink Doctor Who. This one's a size, what is it? Size medium, which isn't too bad. Don't mind a size medium or a size large. That will sell well as well on eBay, maybe $20 there too. So, oh, last item, another kids item. Not that I buy a lot of kids wear, but I bought two pieces today. It was a Messi FC Barcelona jersey. This one is a size 12, a kid's size 12, but it was just in perfect nick. And it's more authentic than it's not, I guess. I mean, it's not authentic, but it could easily be. It's in very good condition. It's even got the embroidery as well on the logo. So, you know, it's a bit more genuine than it isn't. It's kids wear, but it might sell for about $25, hopefully, from a Messi jersey perspective. So, geez, there was a lot of items there. I bought a heap of sort of clothing items in the sense of t-shirts. I bought 9 pairs of shoes and then all the retail arbitrage. So I haven't looked at the total spend today, but it's going to be a lot higher than what it would normally be on a standard, you know, sourcing Thursday. So there's a heap to get into the system, as I always do. There's a heap to list tonight, as I always do. Hopefully you got a bit of a kick out of seeing the thrifting items and seeing the retail arbitrage. You're doing it yourself and going out and buying these items and making the same sort of profit. Let me know if you like this style of video, me kind of just sitting back and just showing you all the items that I bought, or would you prefer to be doing it as I go, you know, live in the field and showing you as I pull up at each stop what I ended up purchasing at the previous. So I can do it either way. I'd love to get your feedback on what you would prefer. But yeah, sort of been a big day. A lot of items purchased. I've got a bit to do on the computer, so I'm going to wrap this video up right there. Remember to give this channel a subscribe if you get any kick out of reselling whatsoever. If you want to learn more, this channel is going to be perfect for you. And give the video a thumbs up as well. I've seen a few thumbs down of late, which I don't really know why the thumbs down are coming about, but try and give me a thumbs up. That would be appreciated. They really don't faze me, the thumbs down, but hopefully I don't get a few. Hopefully I don't get too many more of them, because you don't want to be getting that many of them. But thanks very much for watching. I'm rambling. I will catch you in the next episode. Appreciate you tuning in. Bye for now.